sizi gelecek. Today I'm going to talk about second industrial revolution. Since we are together here with you guys, you can ask questions anytime. Second industrial revolution is associated with extensive use of coal, iron, steam engines, oil, steel, and the start of internal combustion engine, electricity, and rapid communication. So all these happened. All these happened between 1870s and 1910. So just before First World War, oil, steel, coal, internal combustion engine, electricity for illumination and power source, and rapid communication between cities and between continents is provided. Oil, petroleum is added to coal as the source of energy. Steel is started to being manufactured, and skyscrapers in New York, for example, has started building. High-rise buildings were started to make up at the beginning of the century. Internal combustion engine is invented. Electricity for powering, for lighting, for factories invented. Electric motor is invented. And telegraph, telephone, and radio is again invented in the second industrial revolution. First industrial revolution was machines and factories and steam engine. Second industrial revolution is more into internal combustion engine, and many people say it is electricity. So invention of electricity and use of electricity, use of steel, etc., communication is the second industrial revolution, just before the First World War. Furthermore, research and development labs were founded. Technical university education emphasized engineering and chemistry. So technical education, technical universities were specialized. Germany, for example, it's very interesting in those years. Germany spent as much education as on the military. So that amount of money has been spent at the turn of the century. A lot of money went into education and research. US patents tripled, German patents quadrupled, dört katına, between 1875 and 1905. Okay, that's very important. In 1912, Edison's laboratory was one example of organized research institutions. That's actually the first one among others. Organized research institutions, a company or a place by person is built. Engineers are hired, and what they do is invention, so doing research in laboratory. Before that, only clever people, only people in the universities were doing research. But after these starts, research laboratories by private companies and private people and government were put in place. History of nature was also reformulated. In 1824 article on dinosaurs and 1830 estimate of Earth age about 2 billion years, which is today 5 billion years, challenged biblical Genesis, which hypothesizes the Earth age as 7,000 years. Germans discovered human Neanderthal remains in Germany. That's why we call it Neanderthal. At the beginning, at that time, due to body shape, they were assumed that they were more primitive than humans, but later we understood that they were not primitive, they were different. Then Darwin came out. Origins of Species, although many things are not that clear today. I mean, it's not theoretically sound, but generally true. He proposed natural selection and origin of species in the article. So that was actually a very interesting beginning. Pasteur, Louis Pasteur, proposed the germ theory in 1870, that leads to safe milk and packaged foods, pasteurization, killing germs. The idea of killing germs is invented.
What is germ?
Microbe. Lister's antiseptics, chemical fight against germs with alcohol, etc. So surgical antiseptics. Robert Coase. Isolation of bacteria of tuberculosis verum, and then later finding the remedy for it, was industrial revolutionary work in biology and public health. In the earlier days, in 1600, 1700, the surgical rooms were full of blood and dirt, and people, the doctors thought that if there is a lot of dirt during the operation is more successful. So there were no cleaning between patients, etc., in operation. And many people were dying from infection. So the idea of germs, he invented after 1870s. Then they started cleaning operation rooms, etc. Okay? In surgical operations. Yeah. In surgery, clean surgery. So Lister said, if we clean the operation room, then infection from bacteria, the possibility of severe infection from bacteria can be reduced. So they started cleaning tools, etc., in surgery, so that in the room, so that infection rates went down. Again, Listerine was from those years. In the chemistry, John Dalton's Dalton yasaları. John Dalton's atomic theory led to Dmitri Mendeleev's periodic table. Then, later, Nobel found dynamite in 1869. So all those years, 1870s. Dalton is earlier. So Nobel found explosive, not only for killing people, but only for constructing roads, mining, and all those kind of reasons. Dynamite is started to be used. Germany was very moving very fast in those years. They made soaps, pharmaceutical items, chlorine, acids, dyes, artificial flavors, fertilizers, gübre, photographs, filming, silent films, photosensitive materials, photosensitive chemicals to make films, etc. Synthetic fabric, nylon, rayon were found during the turn of the century. That image shows BASF factories in 1881, chemical factories. In those years, obviously, we should make a note that worker rights, child labor, environmental issues were not addressed. So it was all dirty business. In Britain, British people were very interested in steel, because they had coals and they were into railroads. Bessemer, the guy Henry Bessemer, invented a way of producing steel in a big quantities rather than in small pots. He invented blast furnace in 1851. In the Bessemer process, they put iron from the top continuously. It melts, burns, whatever, and from the bottom, just like a cube structure, they take the steel from the bottom continuously. From time to time, they take the steel from the bottom. And they also push some air into, burning steel, burning iron, so that carbon, excess carbon in iron is burnt using oxygen, and steel, low carbon steel, remains at the bottom. So that is not as easy, but generally that is the process. So in big quantities, they started making steel. Using that steel, big buildings were manufactured. William Jenney built the first steel skyscraper, first steel big building in 1884. And on the left, steel buildings. Many buildings are in steel in the United States. Another example was Gustav Eiffel, made Eiffel Tower in 1889. Okay. At the turn of the century, 1870s, United States was moving very fast. Before that, when was the United States independence? The Civil War was 1861-1865. Civil War in United States. So in between 1861 and 1865, there was a civil war in United States, North and South, right? After that is finished, I think 49 states, not 51. Today's America was almost formed. to some degree, and new constitution, etc., all the rights. Then they started progressing more rapidly after the war. So that also corresponds to Second Industrial Revolution time. In 40-50 years, they moved tremendously ahead of Europe. So that by the 1914, United States was becoming world leader in everything, in front of Britain and Germany and France. They were producing 40% of global steel, more than Germany, Britain, and France combined. United States was producing more steel. Later, it increased further. Another part of the Second Industrial Revolution is transportation. Before that, there were horse cars. Horse cars didn't need rubber tires, but then they invented rubber tires. So rubber tires were used in bicycles and cars after 1850s. And the name of the guy is Charles Goodyear. So Goodyear actually is the name of the guy. İşte bundan geliyor. And also, probably, I'm not sure about this, Hankook is also Korean name for the tires. Maybe they have thought about it, maybe not. Maybe they did. As a second to Goodyear. There were different bicycles, there were funny bicycles on sale. So transportation was an issue because city life was improving. So transportation of people by bicycle and by motorcycles were, after invention of motorcycles, it was very interesting. Paris'te bulvarın ismine bakın. Sivastopol, B okunuyor ya. Sivastopol bulvarı. That was also interesting. In those years, after First World War, yeah, there were no passports. Even before, there were no passport. If you don't like the country you stay, you move to another country. No one says nothing. Later, after Balkan Wars, government issued a permit to travel. Permit to travel was asked for people if they travel. That laid a certain piece of paper saying that, with the sign on it, saying that this person is free to go to, for example, Samsun in Ottoman times. In-country travel was also restricted for a certain time. For example, you are living in Izmir, you cannot go to Istanbul. In order to go to Istanbul, you need to get a permit from the kaymakam. Okay? It was all sokağa çıkma yasağı all the time. Kind of travel restriction. That later became bounded by countries and later taken the name of passport. Now citizenship is invented with those jurisdictions, and if you are the citizen of, for example, Germany, then you should get the passport from the passing papers from the Germany. So then citizenship is, let's say, invented. Before that, there were no citizenship. If you can talk in Germany, if you can talk in German, go there and live, or whatever, or vice versa. Therefore, in many old scholars, for example, the scholar is grown up in Italy, and he or she doesn't like the environment or doesn't like the person, he goes up to Russia and continue his studies in Russia. So the scholars were, or Germany, or travel between those countries by scholars were very common, probably by other people too. Internal combustion engine, this is Otto and Benz, which was the Benz? Probably the one on the left is Mercedes, first car, I think. Carl Benz and Daimler in 1880s and 1868 invented internal combustion engine. So regular gasoline engine is invented. At the same time, electric engines were also invented with batteries, but due to the range issue with the electric cars gradually died out at the turn of the century. Actually, electric cars were invented before gasoline cars. And trolleys in the city transportation. Buses with electricity, and electricity is provided from the upper ladder. Electric powered streetcars and cable cars. What? Kablo. Sweden. Telephone tower in Sweden with 5,000 connected lines. It was used between 1887 and 1913. Nokia deyip geçmeyin yani. Sonuçta onlar çalışmışlar. Onun avantajını şimdi yaşıyorlar.
Çok şey görünüyor.
Ne yapsınlar işte, gelişiyorlar. Sonra yer altına alıyorlar. Her hatta bir tane şey çekersen, merkezden kablo çekersen öyle olacak. Para var ki çekiyorlar. What is cable car? San Francisco'da var çok. Başka yerlerde de var. İstanbul'da bir tane var. Tramvay demek değil aslında cable car. Tramvayın bir türü. Yer altında kanalı var. Buhar makinasıyla şey gibi, teleferik gibi tramvayı çekiyorlar. Yani kendi içinde motor yok.
Sessiz sürüşüyor.
Tabii. Tüm şey, Beyoğlu'ndaki tramvaya bindiniz mi?
Ya.
Ha? Füniküler'e. Ama Beyoğlu'ndaki füniküler değil adı. Tramvaydır onun. Tünel. Füniküler Taksim'den Kabataş'a yine de verdiler. Öbürü de füniküler ama öyle demiyorlar yani. Füniküler cable car demek zaten. Fransızcası galiba. İki tane vagon var. Biri çıkarken diğeri iniyor. Denge olsun diye, asansör gibi. Yani tek bir taneyi çekip bırakmakla uğraşmamak için iki tane yapıyorlar ki vagon ağırlıklarınızda. Sadece insanların farkı. Aslında insanlar da dolu. Dolayısıyla çok bir fark etmiyor yani. O şekilde terazi gibi çalışanlara cable car diyorlar. San Francisco'da falan adam caddenin bilmem neresinden bilmem neresine kadar gidiyor ya. Açıktan gidiyor. Cable altta kanal içinden çekiyor. O şekilde onlara cable car diyorlar.
Bu kadar kablonun yere döşenmesi aslında az.
Hangi kablolar?
Kablolar olsun.
Öyle abi. Şimdi sonra şey çıkıyor. Çift kablo çekmiyorsun. Demet yapıyorsun. Renkli içinde. Demetin içinde mesela 50 tane var. Bu şekilde şeyler yapıyor. Şu Şu anda da öyle. Yani mahallelerinizde PTT kutuları var. PTT kutularından evlere kadar tek tek kablo geliyor. Mahalleden sonraki kutuda herkes yani konsantratörü var mı?
Yeni kablo eklemek istediklerine bir daha
port olması lazım. Port yok diyorlar ya. Kablo yoksa port yok deniyor.
O zaman her şey kazılıyor. Yeniden tekrar.
Tabii tekrar çekiliyor. Fiber çekiliyor. Şimdi fiberde çok kablo yerine fiber var. 10 bin tane yerine bir fiber çekiyorsun. Ama yetmediğince ikinci fiber çekiyorsun. Diesel. Bu da adamın soyadı. Last name. Rudolf Diesel invented diesel engine for more powerful and slow for factories and drilling equipments and oil pipelines for trucks, ships and boats. Diesel engine. It's little different, but same kind of engine. Evet. U harfiyle mi? M harfiyle mi? Artık orası tartışılır. Birkaç ülkede U, diğerleri M. London Metro and Paris Metro were opened in those years, 1863 and 1900. In Istanbul, it was 1875. That Taksim cable car was built. So underground transportation notion started in Second Industrial Revolution. '06, they drove tunnels through Alp mountains between, I think, between Italy and Switzerland, probably. Between Italy and Switzerland, or, yeah, that's the case.
Hocam, motorlar yeni keşfedilmiş. Tünellerin kazın gücü insan mı?
İnsan ve dinamit. Dinamitle kazıyorlar. Vagonlar yapıyorlar. Tren yolu döşüyorlar. O vagonlara kürekle atıyorlar. Gidiyor. Daha önce vagonsuz dönemde hayvanla. Olmadı insanla. Ama dinamit var.
Yani. Dinamit de çok yıkıcı olmalı.
İşte yıkıyorlar. Yıkılıyor. Ondan sonra küçük küçük. Ondan sonra o yıkılan yeri boşaltıyorlar. Bir daha yıkıyorlar. Destek koyuyorlar. Kazıyorlar. Paris. Paris metro. That is one figure. Again, France. Showing the structure in Paris metro in those years. Sea transportation was also improving. Before those years, in 1600, etc., steel was not available, so ships were made from wood. But with the Second Industrial Revolution, with the abundance of steel, they started making ships from steel. When they start... Efendim? Anneni arar mısın oğlum? Tamam. When they start building ships with steel, they were able to make big ships because it was stronger, and they built ships like Titanic, two big ships, and started putting passengers back and forth between Europe and United States. Steamships, steam engines with coal. And one interesting thing was although Titanic is famous and sunk, there were other ships during the same period that were carrying passengers back and forth. So Titanic, after Titanic, things didn't change. But it was a luxurious big ship. So transportation with steel. Also, military ships were made during those years. Our famous First World War and Çanakkale War in those years, remember, a lot of British ships and German submarines were in place, made by steel and steam engines. Submarines were operated by diesel engines and batteries. This is a picture from Suez Canal when it's made. See, there are Arabs, Turks, and ships passing by. It is opened in, again, a very important date, 1869. So 1860s, 1870 is very important in those years. It's after Civil War in United States, Second Industrial Revolution, and underground metro. Everything was happening in those years. Refrigeration. So refrigerated rail cars, refrigerated train shipping, so that meat, for example, can be carried from one place to another. Meat or dairy can be carried. Even from Australia to Britain, meat and fruit were able to travel because it was refrigerated in the 1870s. Refrigeration at home was not available before. Only ice was sold. Ice was brought to cities from mountains. Later, with the refrigeration factories, with the pumps, they invented making ice by cooling circuit. And ice was sold in cities, in Istanbul, in Europe. So people at home or in groceries or butchers, whatever, were purchasing ice every day. So every day, one task was purchasing ice in the morning. Later, Crossley, the guy named Crossley, I think it's Crossley, invented this item. And that item was ammonia-based refrigerator. It was only working for 2 days, 2 day refrigerator. The operation was first this is the original one today. Take this out, and this is a solar system. The guy is trying to operate in using solar. Take this out and put this on fire. There is an ammonia inside. Ammonia passes from this part to here, evaporates, passes to other part in half an hour. Take it inside. This part starts to cool down for 2 days. until ammonia evaporates back to the other part. And that was used for several, a lot of years, more than 10, instead of refrigerator in homes. Obviously, I'm talking about United States as the as the foregoing in industry. Maybe there were few in Istanbul or that came from overseas. So in the old days, there were no washing machines, no refrigerators, and there was cross the ice ball. In submarines, actually, first submarine was made by, not made, but made for Turkey by Abdülhamid. It was the first submarine to fire a torpedo from underground, underwater. It's probably this one I found it. So experimental submarines were available, but 1886, that was the first submarine to fire a torpedo underwater. Again, battleships and the ships, arms race between Britain and Germany started before First World War. And that actually led to First World War and included Ottomans into the war, these kind of battleships. Air transportation was started. Hot air balloons with the one balloon, Giffard, Henry Giffard, took 15 mile flight with a steam engine, with a small steam engine. He was able to travel 15 miles. Which is very important because it is an early day, 1852. 1849, Cayley made a glider. So he flew, he said he can fly. Cayley's cycle, 1849. Around 1900, Zeppelins were made. Again, the guy's name was Zeppelin, therefore the name stayed as Zeppelin. Commercial flights were being made by 1900. So in Europe, people were traveling with Zeppelins filled with hydrogen gas. But unfortunately, hydrogen gas was very dangerous, and after several of them burned, they said they are not going to make any more Zeppelins because it was too dangerous and people were not flying with it. So commercially, it was finished. Just like the supersonic Concorde jet plane. In the France, there was an accident. All the passengers were died. After the accident with the Concorde plane, nobody flew with that commercial flight, and they suspended flight. And then later, they stopped making Concorde because nobody was flying because it was too dangerous. Wright Brothers, first plane, 1903. It was similar to a car engine on the plane, and it was able to fly a long distance. Battery was found in 1800, but by the turn of the second industrial revolution, it was improved a lot. And also electricity generation was made possible by bought by Edison and Tesla and others also. Each small company established their distribution network. So the, you make a electricity making company, you pull the wires and distribute electric to surrounding neighbors where you can run the cables. There were no interconnected system. So there were companies producing electric like gas stations and distributing power to surrounding area. In 1831, theoretical and maybe practical, Faraday, British guy Faraday, built an electrical generator so that you can produce electric. Okay. Then it is later improved by Siemens, the guy named Siemens. With the Siemens improvements, people were able to generate electric not only by accumulators but also with mechanical input. So that's very important. And British power plants came 2 years after Edison's light bulb in 1879. So light bulb was invented. Before that, what was the common source of electric? What was the thing on the left? Fikir söyleyin. Soldaki ampul değil. Ama ne? Işık veriyor.
LED.
Ha?
LED tarzı bir şey.
LED olur mu canım? LED kaç yılında bulundu? Semikondaktör.
Halojen ampulü.
Değil. Halojen ampul, normal ampulle ampul da ampul da ampul. Ampulden önce. Şöyle söyleyeyim. Kaynak makinesine baktınız mı hiç? Işık çıkartır. So it was an arc lamp.
Hocam aynı olabilir mi? Normal ampul.
In the arc lamp there was an electric jump between two points. When electric jumps, it makes illumination. So there is an adjustment here. It keeps, you adjust it precisely so that it makes an arc. And from time to time you need readjustment because some part of the electrode is burned. So you need to get it closer every day, for example. Every day it must be a little bit closer because electrode is corroded. So that was the case. It was also inefficient, but that was the case for electric lighting before electric light bulb. Edison made a small, tiny line, not arc, but so that its resistance is somewhat high and somewhat low. It passes electricity to a certain degree, and as it passes, it heats up and starts glowing. At the same time, it does not disappear because there is vacuum inside. If there is an air inside, it will oxidize, it will burn. So it will be vacuum inside and tiny little wire, it gives the light. Which one? Arc? No. Çok yüksek voltaj değildir ki. Ya yüksek olsa ne olur? Dokunmazsın yani. Arkın mı? Ark lambasına. Evet, şey olmasın diye, oksidasyon olmasın diye onu vakum içinde yapmışlardır, Allah bilir. Çünkü oksidasyonun sebebi hava. Hatta duymuşsunuzdur. Gazaltı kaynağı diye duymuşsunuzdur. Argon kaynağı diye sanayi sitelerinde. Orada mesela normal kaynak makinesi gibi böyle çubuk vardır ya kaynak makinesinde, onu değdirirsin çıs çıs çıs yapar ama elektrot gider. Argon kaynaklarında bir taraftan da tüp bağlıdır, gaz verir oraya. Oksijen olmadığı için o oksidasyon olmaz, çok daha iyi şey yapar. Tutar. Argon kaynağı derler ona. Yani argon gazı reaksiyona girmediği için o gazla şeyi yok ederler. Oksijeni olmayınca kaynak iyi olur. Öyledir yani o gördüğün. So arc lamp was the standard for early cars has karpit lambası. Ne oldu? Karpit lambası diye bir lamba var. Chemical. Sodyum bilmem ne bilmem ne bileşeni. O malzeme yanıyor. Yani gaz lambasının biraz daha parlak yananı. Lüks lambası gibi. O şekilde aydınlatma vardı. Sokak aydınlatması falan vardı. Gündüzleri şey yapıyorlar. Akşam biri geliyor kibritle yakıyor. Sabaha kadar o sokak lambası yanıyor. By 1900 appliances such as refrigerators, fans, vacuum cleaners, see this vacuum cleaners were available in expensive homes. Newspapers were becoming more and more popular. So London Times was able to be printed 1,000 copies per hour. Per hour, 1,000 copies per hour. So at that speed, they were able to reproduce printing. Penny press reduced cost and made accessible to the masses. British Charles Knight's Penny Magazine circulated 200,000 copies in the first year, 1832. British newspaper circulation expanded by 300% from 1836 to 1854. So it was tremendous increase in communication by press. Newspapers moved from elitist to popular tones and adopted political biases. So this was also interesting at the same time. Very few magazines were printed in Ottomans. Before, printing was something related with educated people, but later uneducated people were able to also read certain printed items. Tabloid journals, British tabloids came out during that time, fake journals, etc. Postal service was started to form in today's format using postage stamps. Before, there were no stamps. The recipient was, I said that, recipient was paying money to the postman. But with Penny Post Company, postal service was able to made. And regardless of distance, single rate postage was available. It was before 1950s, 1850s. This is also interesting time. Morse telegraph, 1844, enabled high-speed, long-distance communication. Undersea cables connected Britain to France, not United States, in 1850. And after 8 years, they started laying down cables from Britain, Ireland, Britain to Canada, because that path was short. Instead of going to New York, they first went to Canada, then go down from the ground. So Britain to France and Ireland to Canada, cables were laid out.
Hiç suyla uğraşmadan alttan girip alttan çıkıyorlar.
Hayır, hayır. Öyle değil. Gemi var. Arkasında koca bir makara var. Aça aça gidiyor makarayı. Balıkçı gemisi gibi.
Kablo suyun üstünde mi kalıyor?
Yok, dibe çöküyor. Dibe çöküyor. Sallıyorlar yani aşağıya ama dibe kadar gidiyor. Zannetmiyorum Dubai'li asacaklarını, çünkü mutlaka başına bir iş gelir.
Altta da gelmiyor mu başına?
Gelmiyor, sabit dip. Çok derin yere belki gitmiyorlardır. En fazla derin yer 3000 metre, 4000 metre çukurlar haricinde. 3 kilometre aşağı gidiyor. Onu da belli hızda bıraktıkları için yavaş yavaş düşüyor suyun dibine. O şekilde. Ama öyle az bir şey değil yani. 3000 kilometre mi ne yani? 3000 mi? 5000 mi kilometre mi? Saçma sapan büyük bir rakam.
Masraflı.
Masraflı ama o telegraftan para kazanıyorsun işte. Bedava yapmıyorsun ki. So 1876 Alexander Graham Bell patented the telephone. Bell telephone. Bell. Again 1870. So 1870 is very important year. Okay, corner. Lumiere brothers in France invented films. Before that, in the fairs and small towns, they were showing images in dark rooms. Instead of viewing films, movie films, they were displaying still images, photographs in big screens by projection. Still images. So people were paying for to see certain things. Probably there were also nudity in those pictures. Okay. Or things that they cannot see from that town. So one person comes into town, makes a dark room somewhere in a building, and they started charging money for showing certain pictures. Okay, it was very interesting. Then Lumiere later invented moving version of that still pictures, because they were taken one after another in the field, then shown one after another in the salon, in the audience. And basically they invented movie film in 1895. It was silent, of course, because there was no way of recording sound to film at that time. First videos were available in these links. Let's try. This is Lumiere family. Renklendirilmiş. This is so early. Bir sağdan bir soldan öpüşme, Fransız usulü aynı. Otomobilde bu yani. Otomobile binip gidiyorlar. Misafir uğurluyorlar. şapkalısın. Okay.
Tüm film bu mu?
Evet. Another one. Bir dakika, yanlış şey bastık. Şuna basayım. ...1890. Burası Bağdat'tı galiba.
Kudüs yazıyor hocam.
Ha, Kudüs'te evet. Bu Almanya galiba. İtalya. Moskova. Ses geliyor mu öbür tarafa? Tokyo.
Ses yok hocam.
Sesi de gönder diye bir seçenek vardı ekranı paylaşırken. Müzik çalıyor arkadaşlar. Görüntüyle alakası yok. Demek onu da seçersem ha?
Öyle miydi o?
Olabilir. Kafasında ip var değil mi birisinin?
Arabayı bir insan.
Olabilir. İngiltere. Luna Park'a. O kadar çok atlar ki insan şaşırıyor. Otomobil gibi. Uzun. Hoş. So this is good enough. Wireless. Wireless communication was made possible by Marconi first transatlantic radio message. Before Marconi, there was communication between two rooms, between two buildings, spark transmitters, but Marconi were able to transmit a signal so big so that it was picked up from United States. He transmitted it from Europe and it was they were able to pick up from United States. So it was wireless communication. It is when was the cable? So Ireland to Canada cable was 1858. See? That was cable. After 40 years, wireless communication was possible. 40 years was like 1980, Kenan Evren time, and now. So it is quite a significant time. Okay, I think we came to the end of second industrial revolution. In the second industrial revolution, electric, gasoline, steel, and communication. These are second industrial revolution. I am not talking about factories here. Factories were also improved, of course. Factories, buildings, etc. But generally, electric is interesting. Manufacturing with the power of electric and gasoline, moving with the gasoline and electric rather than steam engine. That was the difference. In the third industrial revolution, will include manufacturing process. So serial production, production lines, right? Production lines and manufacturing techniques determine third industrial revolution. That's it. So let me stop recording, and if you have any questions, you can ask.